This is Blackjacks Weekly.
Presented by Bud Light on 97.3 ESPN.
Live from Chickies and Pete's in Egg Harbor Township. With your hosts, the voice of the Blackjacks, Nick Kosko.
And head coach, Ron James.
Now, Blackjacks Weekly.
Live from Chickies and Pete's in Egg Harbor Township, it's Blackjacks Weekly presented by Bud Light. I'm your host, Nick Kosko, joined alongside by Atlantic City Blackjacks head coach, Ron James. It is week 10 already in the Arena Football League season. If you can believe that, we are flying by. We're about to approach July next week. Blackjacks coming off a hard-fought defeat against the number one Albany Empire this past weekend, 63-61. So, Coach, now that I bring you in, down to three games left. It's the fourth quarter of the season. I know you like to split into thirds, but I think for the fans that got there, the season's almost over. It flew by. The road trip's almost over. Let's go back real quick to this past weekend against Albany. Backup quarterback Warren Smith comes in for the injured Randy Hippard. Goes off for 7 touchdown passes, over 300 yards, and a rushing touchdown. He was all-worldly, including this guy to my right, Antwane Grant, had the game of his life, it seemed like, this past weekend as well. Guys still come up short. There's a couple things in that game. If they went the other way, you guys are on the winning end of that one. Take me back to that game from beginning to end, the roller coaster of emotions, and how you guys came up just short there.
Well, we came out ready to play. I mean, that's one of the things you'll find out about a good team is that, you know, when their backs are up against the wall and they're injured and everybody's counting them out, that's usually when you play your best game, and it was no different this weekend. We played one of our best games. Unfortunately, we played the best team in the league, and you can't make mistakes when you play the best team in the league. And just that one error, the one turnover we had offensively was enough for them. They got a stop in the game. We didn't get one, and it was a back-and-forth game. And so coming down to those onside kicks and all the things that we were trying to do and trying to spin the clock in our favor, we pulled out every trick we could possibly have and every rabbit out of the hat, and it just wasn't enough for us. But I really like the way our team fought. There are no moral victories in professional football, just victories. But, you know, the one takeaway is that, you know, this is a team that's going to fight all the way through.
And it seems like those mistakes that happened on Saturday are easily correctable. Obviously, the turnover was on, I believe it was either a missed assignment, and there was also a tip ball there. So the turnover really not on the quarterback. It's on a collection of factors. So I would think that low mistake, maybe a few others that happen during, even on some scoring drives, that has to be easily fixable at this point, right?
Well, it really is, but at the same time, you look at it and go, well, you know, if we fix it in play and we don't have those issues, then maybe we pull off a big upset there and set ourselves right. Now we're, you know, fighting our way up a hill to try to get ourselves into playoffs. But the good thing is we play all the teams that are ahead of us. We still have opportunities, but we have to treat this next game going to Washington like it's a playoff game, and we talked to the team about that this morning. I was pretty animated when I told these guys they got to play their best and they got to be ready for this thing, and there are no excuses. I mean, we don't give ourselves any excuses. We don't beg off on losing a game. We lose a game, we lose a game, and I take all the blame for that, and, you know, I got to get this team ready to go this week, and that's the mission.
Let's talk about some of those guys who had standout performances on Saturday. Warren Smith, for one, as we just mentioned before, his stats were gaudy. The best stat line for any quarterback, one of the best stat lines for any quarterback this season, and it was actually the highest combined scoring game of the season between two teams in this league this year. He went off. He was ready to play, and you told me that last week, knowing that, you know, he was your first free agent signing in team history for a reason. You knew how good he was. You guys happened to get Randy Hippard. He's the veteran. He's an MVP. He's the starter. Warren comes in for Randy, who was hobbled by that injury. Comes in, plays the game of his life, and I was easily the best game of his Arena Football League career.
Well, see, the thing about Warren that a lot of people don't understand is two things. One, he is a high school coach, you know, so in the offseason, he coaches football, so he understands the game. And number two is, as a backup quarterback, he actually does prepare to start. I mean, he's one of the few guys, everybody says that, you know, I prepare to start every week, and I'm in the film room, and I'm grinding it out, and everybody's a grinder until it comes time to play, right? But I'll tell you what, Warren Smith, and he does that. Every week, you know, I could show you, Nick, the emails I get from him, the text messages I get from him. He provides what's called, we call it the Warren Report. You know, it's a report on what he thinks can work that week, and he really does prepare. He prepares to start. He prepares other players. He prepares and actually helps Randy prepare to win, too. So, you know, these are great things to have in a backup quarterback, but he also has experience in this league. So, oh, by the way, it's not just he showed up on a scene and he's been writing different reports for us and watching film. He's actually done it. So, it's no surprise to me that he got out there and performed really well. Very confident player, very, very, very energetic type of guy, and he's one of those guys that you can get behind, and players love guys like that. I mean, you could talk to Antwane a little bit longer, you know, down the road about what he thinks about him, but I'll tell you, everybody you bring in, receivers, linemen, they love being around a guy with that type of energy and a guy that's really that committed to the game.
Well, he's got the energy. He's got the swagger. I know we talked about it last week about the things he brought to the table in terms of his intangibles and also what he can bring running the football-wise, because he showed that off a little bit on Saturday as well. And I'll tell you what, we Coffee Jones and I were up in the booth. That play fake to West down near the goal line on fourth down, he ends up keeping the ball himself, hurdles over a man to get into the end zone for a touchdown. I thought West got stuffed at the goal line. I actually did not see that play fake. Usually we're pretty good up in the booth about seeing those types of things. I mean, he is really good at that, and that's an extra element that teams have to prepare for, including Washington this week, considering they have a mobile quarterback in Arvell Nelson as well.
Yeah, you know, that's a play that he actually drew up. You know, he knew that we ran that certain play, and he said, you know what, if I see this, I'm going to pull it. I'm going to look like the outdoor game, kind of a read option type of deal. And he's got that ability. I mean, like I said, he's another coach on the field. He's eyes that understand the game. And he's just got a sense for those type of things. And actually, the two-point play that we ran at the end of the game had an opportunity to tie the football game up. That was the play that Warren drew up as well. So, I mean, this is a guy that he understands the game.
That was a fancy-looking play, I got to say that.
It was beautiful. You know, unfortunately, you know, we had three options, and we went 0-for-3 on the three options. You know, we could have thrown the ball to the guy he threw it to who dropped the football, and then he could have thrown the ball to Wes, or he could have ran it in. And so, you know, unfortunately for us, we chose door number three, and it didn't work out. But like I'm saying, Warren is a pro. He's a guy you want to have on a team. He's a consummate leader. He works at it. And, you know, if the term grinder comes to mind in a great sense with him, he definitely is that. He's a football grinder because he works at it with the high school. He'll go back and forth from a high school 7-on-7 tournament to come into practice. He'll do a lot of different things during the course of the week you don't anticipate. But I just love the energy he brings, like I said. But more than that, having that guy in the corral, so to speak, a guy that's a backup that can walk in there and do things, it's not very common in professional football. A lot of people are saying, "What was you going into the Albany game?" I said, wait a minute. We got talented guys. One of them was sitting right next to you, Antwane Grant. He's got five touchdowns in that game. It was a coming out party for him because, you know what? Everybody takes their turns in that receiver corps. We said it early in the year. A lot of guys weren't believing me. Now all of a sudden you're seeing guys emerge that you're like, where they been all year? They've been here working. They've been here getting ready for those opportunities. And when it presented themselves, he took it.
Do you think that Warren and Antwane have some sort of special rapport? Because obviously you look early in the year, Randy and Lamarck were obviously hooking up a lot. Then Kendrick started coming on strong, and you see Rashad still step in now in light of some injuries, and he's starting to come on strong now. All of a sudden you see Antwane come in, five touchdowns in that game. I think he came into the game with two total touchdowns in the game, and all of a sudden he's going off and he's destroying that Albany secondary. Did Warren and him work on other things during the week? I mean, do they have a special connection you see in practice?
You'd have to ask Twain a little bit more about that, but I just see it like, you know what, he's spreading the ball around. He liked the matchups, and Twain's a tough matchup. It doesn't matter who's on him. He, you know, he's got the speed to go by people. He's got the hands to corral the football when it's out in the open, and he's got the moves to make a guy miss. So, I mean, he's a triple threat that way, and I think that it just was I wouldn't say happenstance, but, you know, there's certain plans that you come into thinking we can work on this guy, and he took it to the next level.
I'll leave you here with this one. Now you guys are 3-6 right now. Right now, just two games out of the last playoff spot right now with only three to play. So it's crunch time now.
Yeah.
Usually teams get desperate in the situation. Would you describe yourselves as a desperate team or a team that's still calm, cool, and collected? You know what you have in front of you. You likely have to win out. You might need a little bit of help. But everybody that you're playing the rest of the way, Washington, Philly, and Baltimore, those are the three teams that are 5-4 right in front of you. So I would say, I mean, are you guys leaning more towards that calm, cool, and collected category?
I throw another term at you. I'd say we're an urgent team. This is an urgent situation. We have to win this weekend. We understand that. To lose this weekend, we'd have to count on everybody else losing to keep us in the hunt, those type of things. We don't want to do that. We want to go down to Washington to handle our business and then worry about next week. So this is everything to us. We said it last week. We've got to be in a playoff mindset. And we took that attitude up to Albany and came up short. We cannot come up short this week. We have to take that same attitude, that same energy, and level of execution into Washington and do what we need to do.
Live from Jiggies and Pete's in Egg Harbor Township, it's Blackjacks Weekly presented by Bud Light. We're going to step aside and take a quick break. On the other side, we'll welcome wide receiver Antwane Grant to the program, talk about his past performance this weekend, and also his look at his career and what he thinks about Atlantic City as a whole. Make sure you keep it locked. Listening to Blackjacks Weekly presented by Bud Light right here on 97.3 ESPN.
There's something magical about baseball. America's favorite pastime.
One of the biggest rivalries in all of sports will begin a new chapter this weekend. when the Yankees and Red Sox go head-to-head at London Stadium in England.
Once it's in your blood, it's fantastic.
It's Yankees-Red Sox this weekend. Coverage starts Saturday at 1 p.m. and Sunday morning at 9:30 on 97.3 ESPN.
South Jersey's home of the MLB playoffs and the World Series.
Ever wonder what ingredients are in Bud Light? Just check the packaging. We brew with hops, barley, water, and rice. Ever wonder what ingredients are in Coors Light? You can't check the packaging. You have to go to their website, download a PDF, and scroll to page 3. There it is. Coors Light brews with hop extract, barley, water, and corn syrup. Bud Light. Brewed with no corn syrup. Enjoy responsibly. Bud Light Beer, AB, St. Louis, Missouri. Based on information available at MillerCoors.com as of January 16, 2019.
Tropicana Atlantic City is not just a 24-hour gaming destination. It's a premier resort providing entertainment for everyone. Located on the beach and boardwalk, it's home to a wide variety of restaurants, bars, pools, and their very own IMAX theater. This season, Tropicana Atlantic City is proud to team up with the Atlantic City Blackjacks as the 2019 inaugural season presenting sponsor. For more information, visit Tropicana.net. Must be 21 or older. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
Tilton Fitness, the official gym of the Atlantic City Blackjack players and Diamonds Dance Team, invites you to visit one of our 7 locations throughout New Jersey. Try one of Tilton Fitness's award-winning group exercise classes with over 125 to choose from every week. Use our state-of-the-art cardio and resistance equipment. Take a swim in our pool. Relax in our jacuzzi, steam room, or sauna. And complimentary babysitting for up to 2 hours. Tilton Fitness. See what we have to offer you.
With approved credit requires GMF financing. On some models, see dealer for details.
Bennett Chevrolet's summer savings event is going on now because we're overstocked and need to move over 200 vehicles ASAP.
So Bennett has just announced we're selling every new vehicle in stock at $1,000 below the GM supplier employee price. Plus, you keep all the rebates up to 25% off the MSRP.
Yes, $1,000 below. And all the rebates up to 25% off the MSRP on your choice of any new vehicle in stock. Plus, there's 0% financing available that can save you thousands more on some of our most popular vehicles. And if you need trade-in assistance on your run-down, burned-out old trade, Bennett just announced we're giving a minimum $8,000 for any trade, no matter its condition, towards any pre-owned vehicle in stock. Imagine how much more your nice trade could be worth. And our non-commissioned sales consultants are paid on your satisfaction, not on how much you spend. Find new roads at Bennett Chevy, Egg Harbor Township, and BennettChevy.com.
Never go hungry when you have Stir It Up Catering right around the corner. Established in 2002, Stir It Up caters events from Cape May to Philly and everything in between. Catering services range from elegant dinner parties and large weddings to casual food for a laid-back gathering. Standing by the Jersey Fresh motto, Stir It Up Catering supports local farms and fisheries by selecting all homegrown products. Stop by their new storefront off Tilton Road in Egg Harbor Township or go online to stiritupnj.com.
The doctors at Reconstructive Orthopedics are dedicated to getting you expert orthopedic care you need for your bone, joint, muscle, or ligament injury or condition. When you need exceptional care focused on you, see the same orthopedic doctors that treat the Atlantic City Blackjacks at Reconstructive Orthopedics. Available in Bordentown, Cherry Hill, Medford, Morristown, Sewell, Vineland, and Voorhees. Reconstructive Orthopedics, focused on you.
Ever wonder what ingredients are in Bud Light? Just check the packaging. We brew with hops, barley, water, and rice. Ever wonder what ingredients are in Coors Light? You can't check the packaging. You have to go to their website, download a PDF, and scroll to page 3. There it is. Coors Light brews with hop extract, barley, water, and corn syrup. Bud Light. Brewed with no corn syrup. Enjoy responsibly. Bud Light Beer, AB, St. Louis, Missouri. Based on information available at MillerCoors.com as of January 16, 2019.
This is Blackjacks Weekly.
Presented by Bud Light on 97.3 ESPN.
Live from Chickies and Pete's in Egg Harbor Township.
Back here at Chickies and Pete's in Egg Harbor Township, it's Blackjacks Weekly presented by Bud Light. Nick Kosko joined alongside now by Blackjacks wide receiver Antwane Grant joining the program. I mean, every time I say your name, I'm thinking back to Saturday. Because I think I called, what, 5 touchdowns? And what'd you have, 12 catches on Saturday? You were going off, my man, on Saturday.
Yeah. it was one of them games where I just felt as though, you know, I just needed to, you know, step up with Kendrick going down. It was a great game, from a great coming out party for me, great game to, you know, showcase my talent, step up and, you know, try to lead our team to a victory.
Now, you mentioned stepping up in the absence of Kendrick Gaines. Obviously, you've been one of the main starters at wide receiver this entire season. Obviously, you, Lamar, Kendrick, obviously, you throw Rashad still in there as well. But it took you till this long to, quote-unquote, break out. But as Coach mentioned before, you've been working all season long in the preseason, obviously, in training camp, and obviously all the way through the regular season. You just haven't had that stat gaudy game yet, but you've made some very tough catches throughout some of these games, including in some of the big wins that you guys have had so far this year. What do you attribute your big performance on Saturday to from last week?
Just staying ready. Just ready for the opportunity. Preparing, you know, like it is going to be a big game for me. You know, a lot of credit goes to, you know, my quarterback, Randy Hippert, like you said, Warren Smith. We do a lot of, you know, little things in the meeting room where we're, you know, always getting ready. So just always being ready for the opportunity, preparing like I'm going to be, you know, have a breakout game, and credit that to it.
Let's talk about that quarterback rapport. Obviously, yeah. Randy was a star for most of the season. He went down with the injury a couple weeks ago. Warren stepped in last week. I mean, he found you in every which way on that field. And I asked Coach this before, and I wanted to ask you as well. Obviously, you build certain rapports with different quarterbacks. You play with Randy all throughout this year. You're playing with Warren now. Did you guys build a different kind of rapport than you did with Randy, or is every quarterback different in that way, or because it's the same system and the same teammates, is it kind of the same and you just happen to have a big game on Saturday?
I would just say with Warren, I always had like a good feel with him. I always felt as though this is going back to training camp. I always felt Warren was, you know, he was a starting quarterback, you know, no matter. We had Randy, we had Warren. Whoever's in the game, I just felt as though they were always going to make plays. But with Warren, I just know Warren's special. You know, I like Warren. He's a leader. The way he approaches the game, his work ethic, is second to none. So, you know, I'm a big fan of Warren.
Let's talk about your career a little bit. So you've had stints with the Cincinnati Bengals. You had a stint with Saskatchewan up in the CFL as well. Talk about those pit stops first. And obviously, you're coming out of Western Kentucky, so you were looked at, and you had NFL potential. What happened in those two stints with the Bengals and obviously with Saskatchewan that led you ultimately here to the Arena Football League?
Just timing. With Cincinnati, it was a great opportunity for me. And then with Saskatchewan, it was another opportunity that I got to take advantage of. I was up there for 2017, 2018. But yeah, it was just a great time for me. You know, I would love to go back. You know, that's always the goal. So that's just what we're working towards.
So as a receiver, I mean, you know, we don't talk to too many receivers about this, but they all have maybe different answers to it. So comparing it to the outdoor game, to the indoor game, for those who are still kind of new to arena football,
okay.
A lot of things that people say are the angles are a lot different. The field's obviously a lot smaller, so you have to be a little more crisp on your routes. It's all man-to-man pretty much in the Arena League, really no zone. Talk about your experiences playing wide receiver, you know, in the NFL, in college, in the outdoor game, now compared to arena football. Have you had to change your style of being a wide receiver a little bit, or are you just kind of adjusting the fly to the game?
No, it's pretty easy for me to adjust to, just coming from Canada, being in the CFL with the waggle and everything. Of course, with the field being more condensed, that's the only, like, difference with Canadian ball. The field is, you know, more open, it's more space to, you know, I guess do more. And then, you know, with the NFL, it's just a regulated field. So the only difference, I would say, is probably just the size of the field. The waggle, I was pretty used to coming from Canada, so that was pretty much it.
What's it been like for your first time in the arena? You're a rookie by Arena League standards. Yeah. What's the experience been like for you playing basically a different kind of football?
Uh-huh.
Obviously, it's still football, but it's 8-on-8. As you mentioned before, everything's more condensed, it's smaller, it's faster. Particularly now, I mean, your experience in arena football with the running clock, you weren't around when it was, even just last year, when it was the one-minute warnings, and all of a sudden there's almost different strategy involved with it now. So what's your experience been like just in arena football in general?
I would just say, yeah, probably with you honestly get to, you know, get to see the game from a different perspective. You know, with the regular game, it's 11-on-11, so the field's bigger, but with 8-on-8, I just feel as though It makes the bigger game, 11-on-11 game, it makes it more simpler, just because of, you know, how much we game plan with the 8-on-8. It's a little space, so you have to, like, you know, pay more attention to it and things of that nature. So it gives you another perspective, and, you know, where you can appreciate it.
Obviously, the NFL is the glitz and glamour of football in this country. Even the CFL is big up in Canada as well, and it's that you're playing professional football. You're still playing professional football now. The Arena League is the top of the line indoor league in this country as well. But you see a lot of these guys, particularly now with the league going up and down in waves and obviously facing expansion again, so it's rebuilding now the Arena League.
Okay.
So when you look at it from the player's perspective and your own perspective, obviously in the NFL, it's like almost everything's handed to you. Mm-hmm. And then you look at the Arena Football League, where these guys are grinding in this season. Everybody usually has an off-season job as well. Do you see yourself as one of those grinder-type players now? Because obviously your ultimate goal is to get back to the CFL or the NFL at some point in your career. Do you kind of appreciate your time now in the Arena League, knowing that you're basically playing for the love of the game right now, and you're just trying to get better while trying to help a team win a championship?
Definitely. That is the ultimate goal, but the focus right now is, you know, going 1-0 each week, you know, helping this team, you know, secure wins, and, you know, getting a chance to go to the playoffs. So that's the goal.
So we ask everybody who comes on the show this: how do you like Atlantic City? Just the town, the community feel, the nightlife, obviously, and it compared to your other stops, obviously in Saskatchewan, Cincinnati, and where you were in college as well.
Yeah, I mean, Atlantic City is especially the fans. The fans are, you know, they're very loving, they're very welcoming, and I'm right down the street. So I'm from Wilmington, Delaware. So I'm right down the street, and I just feel welcomed here. It's a lot of love. I love the fans, and it's just a great place to be overall.
Now, being from Wilmington, are you an Eagles fan?
I'm actually not. I'm a Dallas Cowboys fan.
Oh no, you can't. Oh boy, you can't say that down here. It's all right. It's still worse than what Coach said before. He's a Patriots fan, so it's all right. Coach, I think, has the upper hand on you now. All of a sudden, Dallas Cowboys. Oh man, we'll edit that part out when we put the show up later.
we'll do just the ring count. Like
we'll just say you are a NFL football fan. How
yes,
about
sir.
That?
Yes, sir.
So you guys, going back to week three, Aiden Washington, guys came up short. And even Coach said it before. You know, you didn't play your best game. The whole team, I'm saying. And yeah, it was only a one-score game. There was missed opportunities, but the game was there to be had. What has to change this week, knowing that you guys are on a bit of a skid right now? It's been a long and tough road trip, but knowing that this is the last game of the road trip, you guys are going back home. He mentioned the team has that sense of urgency now with three games left to win out and get in the playoffs. Is that kind of flip everybody's mental aspect a little bit and say, hey, if we get this one, we're going to be on a roll again and try to make the playoffs?
The goal is always going 1-0. So, you know, as long as everybody does their job, you know, you just do your job. Just do your 1/8. That's what we say. Just do your 1/8. Everybody does their job. And the goal is just to go 1-0. Just be locked in. You know, the number one thing that we have to focus on is no turnover. So as long as we control, you know, control the ball, take care of the ball, things of that nature, we should be good. We'll be fine.
Antwane Grant joining me on Blackjacks Weekly. We are going to step aside and take another quick break. On the other side, Coach will rejoin us. We'll look ahead to the game against Washington this weekend. We'll get this weekend's uniform combination as well. I believe it's one we haven't seen yet before, so stay tuned for that. You're listening to Blackjacks Weekly, presented by Bud Light, live from Chickies and Pete's in Egg Harbor Township, right here on 97.3 ESPN.
Atlantic City Blackjacks football is on 97.3 ESPN. Listen all season as the voice of the Blackjacks, Nick Kosko and Coffee Jones, bring you all the exciting play-by-play action.
Quarterback sneak over the goal line. Touchdown, Blackjacks.
The Blackjacks are in the nation's capital to face the Valor.
This Saturday, kickoff at 7 p.m. It's Atlantic City Blackjacks Arena League football.
On 97.3 ESPN.
We're all in.
Tropicana Atlantic City is not just a 24-hour gaming destination, it's a premier resort providing entertainment for everyone. Located on the beach and boardwalk, it's home to a wide variety of restaurants, bars, pools, and their very own IMAX theater. This season, Tropicana Atlantic City is proud to team up with the Atlantic City Blackjacks as the 2019 inaugural season presenting sponsor. For more information, visit tropicana.net. Must be 21 or older. Gambling problem, call 1-800-GAMBLER.
Ever wonder what ingredients are in Bud Light? Just check the packaging. We brew with hops, barley, water, and rice. Ever wonder what ingredients are in Coors Light? You can't check the packaging. You have to go to their website, download a PDF, and scroll to page 3. There it is. Coors Light brews with hop extract, barley, water, and corn syrup. Bud Light. Brewed with no corn syrup. Enjoy responsibly. Bud Light Beer, AB, St. Louis, Missouri. Based on information available at MillerCoors.com as of January 16, 2019.
Tilton Fitness, the official gym of the Atlantic City Blackjack Players and Diamonds Dance Team, invites you to visit one of our 7 locations throughout New Jersey. Try one of Tilton Fitness's award-winning group exercise classes with over 125 to choose from every week. Use our state-of-the-art cardio and resistance equipment. Take a swim in our pool, relax in our jacuzzi, steam room, or sauna, and complimentary babysitting for up to 2 hours. Tilton Fitness. See what we have to offer you.
Savings include factory rebate and dealer discount. 0% financing with approved credit through Ford Credit. Tax, title, and license extra ends June 30th. Number one claim from 2018 total new vehicle sales per Ford reports.
It's the model year final closeout going on now at number one Lewiston Ford. Here's General Manager Ivan Nelson with more.
That's right. All of our 2019 models are sale priced and moving out. These are not leftover 2018 models. We are closing out all of the 2019s. During this sale, save $7,500 off the MSRP on all remaining 2019 Ford F-150s and Explorers.
Looking for an SUV? Lewiston Ford will save $6,500 off the MSRP on all 2019 Ford Edges, Escapes, and Expeditions.
Or choose to save 0% APR financing for 72 months on all 2019 Ford F-150s, the best-selling truck in America.
Make the money-saving drive to Lewiston Ford, the number one volume Ford dealer in Cumberland County, Salem County, and Cape May County.
We are Lewiston Ford, and we are built Ford proud. On North Delsey Drive in Vineland, online at LewistonFord.com.
At Indeed, we believe a resume is a great way to see an overview of a candidate. But you're not hiring a resume, you're hiring a person. That's why Indeed offers tools that help bridge the gap between a candidate and the resume. Like skill tests, which let you actually see a candidate's abilities in action to make sure they're a good fit for the job. See beyond the resume with Indeed. Experience Indeed for yourself today and get a free sponsored job upgrade on your first posting at Indeed.com/promo. Terms and conditions apply.
The doctors at Reconstructive Orthopedics are dedicated to getting you expert orthopedic care you need for your bone, joint, muscle, or ligament injury or condition. When you need exceptional care focused on you, see the same orthopedic doctors that treat the Atlantic City Blackjacks at Reconstructive Orthopedics. Available in Bordentown, Cherry Hill, Medford, Morristown, Sewell, Vineland, and Voorhees. Reconstructive Orthopedics, focused on you.
Ever wonder what ingredients are in Bud Light? Just check the packaging. We brew with hops, barley, water, and rice. Ever wonder what ingredients are in Coors Light? You can't check the packaging. You have to go to their website, download a PDF, and scroll to page 3. There it is. Coors Light brews with hop extract, barley, water, and corn syrup. Bud Light. Brewed with no corn syrup. Enjoy responsibly. Bud Light Beer, AB, St. Louis, Missouri. Based on information available at MillerCoors.com as of January 16, 2019.
This is Blackjacks Weekly.
Presented by Bud Light on 97.3 ESPN.
Live from Chickies and Pete's in Egg Harbor Township.
Back here at Chickies and Pete's in Egg Harbor Township. It's Blackjacks Weekly presented by Bud Light. Nick Kosko, Jordan, alongside by Blackjacks head coach Ron James and wide receiver Antwane Grant. Final segment of the show. Gentlemen, I think I got spoiled in the uniform combination before, but Coach, I'll let you reveal it. Actually, do you want to reveal it, Antwane? I know the players decide. Is that correct?
I'll let the player. You don't even know when you're doing that. He's going to get the uniform.
He's going to have to hope that everything's set up properly for him. Coach, you know the uniform combination.
White jersey, black pants.
I love it. First time we're seeing it all year.
Yep, exactly right.
Do you like those black pants? I love those black pants.
It doesn't matter what we play.
He's ready to play. That's the right answer. That's what I was looking for.
It's great being young, too. You look good and everything, so don't worry about it. He's good.
All whites. I know we were busting on Center Ray McNeil for wearing the all whites the other week. Coach.
He put the veto on it for this week. So okay. Black pants, he needs them. That's good. Slimming, you know.
Black is slimming and everything. Why do you think I wear black all the time? And I subject myself to long pants and long shirts when I come to the bubble at Egg Harbor City.
Well, you're coming prepared. That's the way it works.
that's good stuff. That's what you got to do. Yeah. So, Coach, real quick, we look at Washington this week. So I would say the biggest key to basically stop the Valor is quarterback Arvell Nelson. We know how good he is. He was a Arena Bowl champion last year. He's a mobile quarterback. He can throw it pretty much anywhere on the field. How do you contain or stop him this weekend?
The biggest thing with Arvell is, you know, make him work the field. I mean, because like any quarterback, the more snaps he takes, the better it is for us, you know, because the propensity to throw a bad ball or have a bad snap or whatever. But he's a great quarterback. There's no doubt about it. I've had him before. He's a competitor. I don't think we can really stop him. We have to be efficient offensively. Guys like Twain are going to get us rolling this week, and that's a big deal for us offensively.
And Antwane, I know you guys had a great week of practice. Do you feel like this is one of your better weeks of practice? Do you guys feel good going into this final stretch of the season?
Definitely. We definitely took a mental step forward, so I feel as though our game plan is good. Mentally, we're all prepared, and we're ready to go.
Well, that's going to do it for us. So you heard from Antwane Grant, of course, head coach Ron James. A couple thanks to give value. Thank you back in studio, our producer, Josh Henning. Just a reminder, next week, Blackjacks Weekly will be on Wednesday, July 3rd, before the 4th of July weekend. So that's Wednesday right here at Chickens and Peach at 6 p.m. on 97.3 ESPN. That's going to do it for us. I am Nick Kosko saying so long. You're listening to Blackjacks Weekly presented by Bud Light right here on 97.3 ESPN.